Game On is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Game On. It's Game On. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Nemo UC will be the other game set to happen tonight. Game one ended in what was a 3-1 victory for UCU men's team. And game two tonight could decide on whether UCU reach the finals if they get the right result like they did in game one, or for Nemo to come out strong and force game three. Brian, we know for a fact that Nemo have time and again written statements both at domestic level and also regional level. They've become a club that tends to run under one man. That is, of course, Captain George
Aporu.
Yes, a very, very, he's an accountant, I think. Yeah, met him in bank so many times. But that said, you look at Nemo Stars driving under one engine, and for me, that is not very handsome, if I should, especially when you're going in such a very tough encounter like UC. UC right now don't look like they're in the mood to actually give this one away. They've been beaten a few times by Nemo Stars, and tonight could be looking like a vengeance time for them to reach the finals.
First of all, for UCU, they'll have the momentum going into this game, because for me, if you pick up a win in game one, it becomes easy for you to sort of find that follow-up in game two. And that being said, for Nemo Stars, they'll be thinking that as much as they've got such names who are outstanding for them, but at the end of the day, it's a team sport. Mm-hmm. It's not just about that one individual, but you also need the quality coming off the bench. Mm-hmm. I need players that can come in there and be the difference for you. And for me, they've got to work like a team, because we know one of the key attributes about volleyball is that you've got to be, very creative, mm-hmm. In terms of who is setting, who is doing what for the team. And you've got to work as a unit. So that is going to come in handy for them. And at the end of the day, it's not going to be an easy game. Obviously, for Nemo, the pressure is now on them because mm-hmm. they lost game one. They understand that any loss right now would see mm-hmm. them getting knocked out at the playoffs, and it doesn't get any harder for them as a team.
Thus, missing out on continental involvement. Yes. The beauty about the playoffs mm-hmm. is that Sportis has two sides, the men and the women. And that for me clearly says that our Sportis have come through quite strong, quite convincing. When I look at the stats right here, 64 sets won, mm-hmm. losing just 10 compared to what UCU had, mm-hmm. 60 sets won and just 21 lost. And for Nemo, 57 sets. That for me speaks volumes. And yeah. I would like to appreciate the volleyball they've played this season, much more different from last season. In that regard, can they be potential winners this season, both in the men and the women, despite the fact that, well, they lost game one in the men's?
Yeah, potentially every playoff every playoff team mm-hmm. is potentially,
I mean, there's always that one particular one that kind of stands out.
This is just
the rest.
Game one. Today is game two. Mm-hmm. So after today, we shall start, making a picture of mm-hmm. who's going to play the finals.
Looking back on this season, so many hardships, so many, so many thick roads taken, especially for you as a vice president, along with, of course, the president herself. I like to believe that you and the support cast have done so much to have the league run without any disruptions. Two seasons back, I hate to take that back, to have that story brought back, but it's unavoidable. We tend to move on from that. But when you look at the challenges currently happening, you want to think that, can they be arrested? We have situations of players complaining about, we can't have volleyball played outdoor. Well, you have the weather conditions that don't favor them at times, mm-hmm. and even then, the surface of the court as well doesn't suit them. Mm. How much solving has been done in that regard?
Well, I can't say we have solved so many of them, but first I have to appreciate that our cadres, who are always there to ensure that these games go on, mm-hmm. are always on ground, mm-hmm. regardless of whether they are paid or not. And for us, it's kudos, because it's not easy. Mm-hmm. And then two, we have, most of our clubs are, self-started. They are not institutional. Mm-hmm. So it is difficult for them to come through, for example, on the obligated fees. So, and those fees are the ones that, feed into us running the game mm-hmm. as easily as possible. Mm-hmm. So if they also get organized and know that, look, we are going to play the league and this is so much we have to pay. Mm-hmm. That would help us, in operational costs mm-hmm. to reduce them. And then three, as a nation, we only have one facility, Lugogo.
Yes.
In as much as we have booked the whole year, we have almost 50 teams in the league.
Altogether, Serie A, Serie B.
Serie B, Serie C, then women. Mm-hmm. So if we have to organize all these games and use that facility,
it's not going
to
be enough.
I don't think there's any other sport that would play. So what we do, we try as much as possible to, mm-hmm. you know, lean on goodwill mm-hmm. from universities. Mm-hmm. We have Nkumba University and UCU mm-hmm. and Sportes. We have used those three grounds mm-hmm. the entire year. It's very, you know, straining financially for these clubs. Mm-hmm. But we are thinking beyond what has happened this year. We have taken lessons from the challenges mm-hmm. and we are hoping that come next year, we are going to have a more centralized game mm-hmm. that is closer so that we can also get our fans and possible sponsors mm-hmm. to come and watch. Because when you only play in universities, there are some sponsors that cannot go into universities. Mm-hmm. For example, the beverages, the adult, you know, beverages, mm-hmm. they cannot go and, you know, sponsor in a university because mm-hmm. you're interfering with the, you know, policies. Mm-hmm. So as a federation, we are looking at, you know, the bigger picture.
Okay.
We are looking at changing the venues and bring them closer and maybe have the indoor, which is very costly.
Very.
And since we are self-financing, mm-hmm. that also becomes, you know, a deterrent, you know, factor.
At this point in time, Brian, every sport suffers at some stage. Well, not football, but every sport, majority of the sports in this country suffer in such familiar, you know, fashions or manner. Lack of money, lack of facility, and this is the kind of it's a disease that has actually eaten up Ugandan sport and taken it to a very deteriorating level. I would imagine NCS, National mm-hmm. Council of Sports, the overseer of all the federations, know these issues, know these problems. They're ongoing, but just maybe they also maybe in a way overwhelmed by the urgency, by the need to be, you know, given out. But that said, volleyball, I think, has grown over the years. We've seen some outstanding players that have gone professional, yep. and that for me is a plus. But moving back to the problem, how much needs to be given now? Because with this conversation about priority sports, this conversation about this gets this much and this doesn't get this much.
I think, first of all, one of the things that NCS, obviously, who are mandated to grow sport, mm-hmm. Did is that they came out and said that they've got priority sports. Now, for me, once you do that and you choose to select a certain, you know, couple of sports, that means that the rest are going to feel left out. They'll mm-hmm. feel like they are not included. And that in itself raises question marks. And interestingly, some will say, where is our comparative advantage? Mm-hmm. Obviously, it's got to be athletics. It's got to be boxing as well. Are we putting in as much as we expect from them? I think we've not entirely done that. And at the end of the day, it comes back to a conversation where, you know, some sports will feel like they are being left out, and then there is sports that are actually being favored. So mm-hmm. it's quite the interesting conversation. But for me, the solution is that we need to continuously have this conversation. Mm-hmm. It needs to be continuously brought to the forefront, because at the end of the day, if we are going to grow sport, then we need people who are passionate about it. Mm-hmm. We need a culture where everyone is hands-on and they are driving towards one objective, which is about developing, which is about building sports as mm-hmm. well. And the beauty about it is that now we've got someone within the ministry who is also closer to the top office, that mm-hmm. is, you know, the Minister of Education and Sports. Mm-hmm. And you're thinking, if we can continuously lobby to her, and we've got all these medals coming through. Recently, we had the gold medals coming from Gold Coast, mm-hmm. from the World Athletics Championships as well. Boxing, when they've gone to the All Africa Games, they've always brought us all this success. So for me, we need to continuously lobby. We need to continuously have this conversation as well, because mm-hmm. it doesn't end. And at the end of the day, that is the only way we are going to grow sport, because we need government to be at the forefront mm-hmm. of the drive.
Mr. Patricia, allow me to ask this question. It's going to sound offensive in a way, but when he mentions disciplines like athletics, they've delivered right from the Commonwealth last season going into this year. When he mentions, I'm going to talk about football. When he mentions boxing, in a way, volleyball, when you look back, when you backtrack 2017, 2018, plus minus the misfortunes of the league. Again, I don't want to bring it back, but when you look at those scenarios or those sceneries, do you think that has contributed in a way that NCS has neglected you slightly because of the lack of success? I'm sorry, but it just has to be the way it is.
Success is not a mistake. Mm-hmm. You have to water it. Mm-hmm. If it's a plant, you've got to water it. So our national team, for mm-hmm. example, if we call them in camp, you write to the ministry, you write to NCS, maybe they respond, but when do they respond and with what? Because the national team that is not a product of the federation. Mm-hmm. It is a product of the nation, because
the nation.
They are representing
yes.
the nation. So these players do not have where to train from. We have an indoor facility. We are thrown out most of the time. Or you ask for days, they say it's fully booked. So where shall we train from as a national team? You are going to, you know, play with people, compete against people who literally
have it all.
in, you know, an indoor facility mm-hmm. that is so much better. So for me, I think it should be a deliberate effort mm-hmm. of NCS to ensure that all federations have a national team mm-hmm. at all age groups. Because when you grow into this sport, it is easy for you to win. Mm-hmm. You have seen these things happen. These athletes didn't win today because they started yesterday. Mm-hmm. They started years back. The preparation was there. They have monitored them. We are lucky to have a school's, you know, feeder. Mm-hmm. Schools play volleyball. Mm-hmm. People have benefited through education and jobs. So these people, they are incentivized. They come and play because they love the sport. They have benefited from it. But now if you're on the national team and you cannot even get transport,
it's sad.
How are you going to win?
I like the way KVC are trying to do. I mean, all this club in Uganda, Kampala Amateur Volleyball Club, sorry. I mean, they've tried to have numerous clinics, tried to, you know, take the game to the schools and, you know, give them the basic skills. But even while you're trying to do that, you'd want to have an inspiration. For me, if I was Nicholas and I'm, 12 years of age, and I'm told that volleyball can change my life, I need to have an inspiration cord. Now, hearing you say what you've just said kind of takes me back in my thoughts and gives me second thoughts. Should I go ahead with the, you know, with the discipline? Should I go ahead with the sport? I know it's two-sided, but in a way, you've got to keep the players going, and in a way, you've got to produce more superstars for the future.
Yeah, we keep pushing as a federation. We are, that is our mandate. We have to have competitions. Mm-hmm. If it is regional, like Zone 5, mm-hmm. you have no idea how many people in this Uganda have goodwill. Mm-hmm. So they support you, but it is not enough because a national team, somebody to wear, mm-hmm. to wear a national...
It's pride.
I mean, you have to be like the Uganda Cranes.
Definitely.
Earning dollars. Mm-hmm. But here, we are giving you 50,000. Mm-hmm. It will not even, you know, take you to the next day. Because you've got to feed right. Mm-hmm. You've got to travel right.
Definitely.
Because these knees, volleyballers need their knees.
I look at the spiking in the palms mm-hmm. and they're always
the
red.
The palms are okay, but the knees. You have to travel from here. Mm-hmm. Maybe your championship is in Kigali. You sit on a bus for, mm-hmm. for 12 hours.
And that is
and
so exhausting.
You're going on the eve of the championship. Why? Mm-hmm. Because you cannot afford
an air ticket.
Time. No, you cannot afford, you know, arriving earlier. Because you cannot afford the hotels.
Well, there is Bombardier now. But quickly, your final message to the peoples out there. Tonight, it's about the playoffs, not about the problems of volleyball, but about the playoffs tonight. Your final message to the country. What can we expect? How much? And the venue so that we can drive the traffic tonight.
Game 2 tonight is in Lugogo, MTN Arena. Mm-hmm. It's 5,000.
5,000 only.
5,000 only.
No VIP, no nothing.
No.
Okay.
We want everyone to come and watch and support our league, mm-hmm. because the winner has to represent Uganda somewhere. So
definitely,
yeah. And the federation is proud, mm-hmm. you know, to be associated with, for example, the media. They're pushing
makers.
Us and these clubs. Mm-hmm. So we hope that everybody will come down and watch and support. It's going to be electrifying.
Thank you so much.
Game 2 is today and Thursday, so both days, mm-hmm. come down.
That is Patricia Humza, Vice President, close to being president, but well, she doesn't want to. But that's a conversation for another day. Game 2 tonight, Nkumba up, rather Nemo up against UCU, the men. UCU won game 1, 3-1. And for the women, in danger facing Makesie, who won game 1, narrowly 3-2. We'll take a very small break. When we get back, UPL is across the country. 5 fixtures, Wakiso set to seek redemption away to the former league champions. And for Chetume, as well, they'll be hoping to recover from that defeat the last time out. That and much more to follow right after this break.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Game on is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.